Welcome to Excel Mehta. In this clip, we will show you how to get total even if VLOOKUP gives error. In this sheet, we are using VLOOKUP to get description based on code. Here, this is our master data. This is our code C for which we want to pick up description and rate. For picking up description, we are using this VLOOKUP. For picking up rate also, we are using this VLOOKUP. And then quantity is available in our data. We are multiplying rate by quantity to get value. And yellow color is where we are picking up data. So I'll apply yellow color to this sales also. But there are two items at the end, E and F, which are not there in master file. So we are not getting description. And we are not getting rate also. And because of that, when we are working out value by multiplying quantity into rate, there also we are getting error. And subsequently, when we are calculating sum, we are not getting sum also correct. Average also we are not getting. Count we are getting, because count function is designed to count numeric figures and exclude error. So it is giving correct count. It is not counting these two cells and counting remaining cell where the output is number and it is giving correct number. And our purpose is how to get this sum. Because many times, even if there are error in one or two item, we should get the sum or total so that we at least get what is the estimate of total amount. Correcting one or two item out of maybe thousands of item may not change the sum or total very significantly. So we'll show you what is the best method to correct it. Let's go to this if error. This if error function is not available in Excel 2007. It's available in the latest version, Excel 2016. And Excel 2019, and even to those who are using Excel 365 plus Excel 2013. But Excel 2007, it is not available. This function, basically when we are doing multiplication, we are adding here if error. Let me tell here, while picking up rate, the same VLOOKUP is there. We are not making any change in VLOOKUP formula. But to calculate multiplication, we are using first if error, then open bracket. Then we give first parameter of if error, the calculation that we want to do. It is basically multiplication of quantity and rate. Then we put comma. And second parameter we have to give, what result we have to give if the calculation gives error. So this formula gives correct answer wherever rate has been picked up by the VLOOKUP. Where rate is not available, then this formula gives not available as the result. And you should note here, you have to put inverted comma around the text that you want to display. I've used not available as a short form, NA as short form of not available. But if you want to type here full not available, you can put that also. So with these two figures getting converted to NA instead of error, sum formula is working. There is no change in sum formula. Similarly, average formula is also working. Count formula was already working earlier. And if you want to check whether average is correctly worked out or not, we can put here sum divided by count and we'll get 14.14, which is the same as average worked out by the formula. So it is tally. So this way we can use if error formula to ensure that error is converted to text, maybe NA or any other text you want. And that is why sum and average both function are working correctly. And this will be applicable to latest version of Excel. What if you are using Excel 2007, as there are many people using in India? We go to this next sheet. In 2007, there was isError function available. So instead of ifError, we use here ifError function. But the only difference in ifError function, we have to use if function also. IsError function, and then as a, its parameter, we give the calculation. So that will give whether this calculation gives error or not. And then we use if function. So if this gives calculation, if this calculation gives error, then the next parameter will be displayed or inserted. That is, we have put NA in the inverted comma, and the if function will put the third parameter if the condition is not satisfied. That means if error is not given out by this formula, then this formula itself will be calculated and displayed. So the disadvantage here is that multiplication formula we have to put twice, which is a minor irritant. But if we are using old version of Excel, then we have to do with this little longer formula. With this formula, this two output are converted to not available, and sum and average is also calculated correctly. So friends, with this, the today's clip is over. In case you want to get this Excel file, you should send me WhatsApp message on the following number so that I can send you link to get this Excel sheet as well as many more Excel sheet which I have prepared as a study note for learning various topics. Thank you and bye.